Hey guys, Marsaken here, bringing another Dragon Ball Z Dokkan Battle video. And so today we're going to be taking a look at the free-to-play Tech Trunks that just got his EZA on the JP side. We're on the private server here again, so I don't know why, as I said in the previous video, it has the weird color scheme, but here it is. I decided to throw on the new support memory as well that just came out with Trunks getting Tapion Sword. The quality of the animation is really, really good. However, not the most useful thing for this run in particular. The support memory, it's called Present from a Hero. It's attack and defense 10% for 2 turns for storied figures allies, which Trunks isn't even on. I just thought it was kind of appropriate for the showcase, right? So we're going to link these guys up here. They only have solid support. Okay, that's interesting. Now, this Trunks seems like he could be interesting for a free-to-play unit. I should specify that, of course. But when we go into his passive details here, of course, on JP with the private server, it doesn't translate any of this. It does show you some useful stuff for, like, team building, like the links and categories and that in English. But fortunately, I have the details up here at the side. So he is a movie hero's lead for 3-key and 77%, or tech types 3-key, 50%. Pretty standard free-to-play EZA, like, leader skill. His super attack is that he infinitely stacks attack, and he raises defense for 1 turn while doing supreme damage. He also has a unit super, which still infinitely stacks attack. It greatly raises defense for 1 turn, does supreme damage to the enemy, and is also all attacks become guaranteed crits. So if he does like an additional normal, everything for that turn is crits, right? And that is activated when he has a Tapion in the same turn. So his passive is attack and defense 120, additional 100% to both when performing a super. He has a medium chance to crit, so even if he doesn't get the unit super, you've still got that 30% crit chance. He gets an additional attack and defense 15% per movie heroes ally on the team. So we are running him on a full movie heroes team here, so he will be getting the full buff. He reduces the attacked enemy's attack by 20% for 2 turns, gives 2 ki to himself, and all allies 40% defense when there's an ally whose name includes Tapion on the team. So that's good, right? As long as Tapion's on the team, regardless of what rotation this guy is on, he is buffing all allies 40% defense, which is pretty good. And then he also gets that if there is a movie boss's enemy, so he won't need a Tapion. Then he also reduces the enemy's defense by 30% for 2 turns, gives himself another 2 ki, and gives all allies 40% to attack if the ally whose name includes Tapion is on the same turn, or if there's a movie boss's enemy. So if you're fighting a movie boss enemy, you don't even need a Tapion on the team, and he's giving all allies 40% attack and defense, and himself 4 ki. So that's pretty decent for a free-to-play support unit. And then obviously if Tapion is on the turn, it doesn't matter about the enemy. And same with the team for the defense, right? So even if Tapion's on the team but not on the rotation, he's still giving everyone 40% defense, which is pretty good. So we did start off with the Tapion on the turn. I think we won't get the 18 key for you. I don't want to do too much damage here, because I want to see what Trunks is going to do. So start of turn, he is at 131k. Now, bear in mind, he gets 100% on super, and then because we're going to get the unit super attack, he greatly raises defense. So he's going to be looking at what, like just being over 300k, which, whilst not being crazy, again, we always have to remember with these particular showcases, he is a free-to-play unit, but we'll see how we get on. So we'll grab the key for you. There we go. We're going to get the unit super, and then we'll pick up the rainbow orbs here for Tapion. And then let's see what Trunks is capable of. Not expecting anything too crazy, but of course he, you know, as a free-to-play support unit, I feel like that's where his strength is going to be. So I guess it depends, right? I mean, if he does a decent attack stat, that'll be nice. 4.4 turn one. That's not bad, because remember, he is going to infinitely stack attack. And because he infinitely stacks on his non-unit super as well, if we get an additional super attack, sadly we didn't, but there's the guaranteed crit. If we get an additional super, he raises his attack again. So potentially in a slightly longer event, he could actually build up to a pretty reasonable number. So since we're just going to finish him off straight away here, let's go ahead and do this. And then we can go straight back to another Trunks turn. But yeah, I mean, his main role is going to be support, right? But as a Trunks, he's on Hybrid Saiyans, he's on Vegeta Family, Youth, Gifted Warriors, Bond of Friendship, Bond of Parent and Child, Earthbred Fighters. This one obviously is on Movie Heroes, and he's on Entrusted Will as well. So there's a few teams where you could put him that even without a Tapion, right? If you're running against a movie boss, he is going to be providing that support. The problem is, without a movie boss enemy or a Tapion, then he's basically not doing anything, right? And again, his links are going to be an issue. Z-Fighters, The Innocents, Royal Lineage, World Tournament Champion, Money, 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 Solid Support, and Shattering the Limit. As you can see, like on this rotation, he just gets no links active at all. Now, we don't have a Tapion on rotation, but we do have one on the team. So we're not getting the unit super. We're not providing the attack support to allies, but we are providing the defense support. And we have the Gamma 1 support as well. So we're at 128k for this turn. That still puts him up to over 300k after supering, which again, as I say, is okay for like a free-to-play unit. But of course, you know, if we start taking him into any of these more difficult events, he's probably going to struggle a little bit. So we're getting AoE'd here as well. So how much has he taken from this? Yeah, 300k. It's quite a lot. But again, the problem with any units that get their defense on super, he gets 100% from his passive and the defense raise from his super attack effect. So of course, he's not going to be good against AoE enemies. And you know, the big bad of the game at the moment is the Fusion Zamasu, who is int in the first turn. So of course, absolutely going to demolish this Trunks. I mean, it's the problem that every tech unit that's going to release has, right? While Zamasu is still the hardest, or even one of the hardest events in the game, unless they're coming out with guard or damage reduction and stuff like that, right? So Trunks, not going to be super useful for the hardest events in the game. I feel like this is a kind of a running trend for the free-to-play units at the moment, though, where they can be decent and they definitely can have their uses in certain stages, but when it comes to, you know, the hardest events in the game, they're not going to be particularly crazy. So we'll do this again here, even without the, like, links or anything, like proper rotation. Goku should be able to finish off Frieza, because I forgot originally I wanted to get the Namek Goku, the Carnival Goku, floated off so that we can have him in slot 1 and then this Goku in slot 2. They're going to have a few links. They're not like the best rotation, but the showcase obviously not about them, so not particularly worried about his performance. Even so, this Goku, the couple of links and then the support that he gets from Tapion, 15 million in slot 2. So definitely looking forward to him coming to global, but let's see. We will get a link active here from, let's keep Piccolo on the rotation because he is providing some support. We do get solid support. What is solid support giving us at level 10? I think, is it actually attack? I think it is. Nope. Doesn't like that. There you go. Attack 15% and all enemies defense minus 20. Okay, you'd think with a link called solid support, it would potentially be defense. But so we've got a lot of support on this rotation, but no Tapion. 138k. So pretty decent. Let's grab these. Get these for you. We'll save any STR orbs here. Well, actually, Tapion's not going to be around, is he, for another couple of turns? So that's fine. Should have really got the super with Gamma 1, but it's all good. So what is Trunks going to be up to here? This is, again, without the unit super. By not having a Tapion on the rotation, he's not giving the 40% attack support. Because in terms of the actual attack for his super compared to his unit super, it's still the same, right? It's just the normal attack raise. So he doesn't get any extra attacking ability. He's not losing any attack from his own abilities, right? His own super attack effect. But it's because having a Tapion on the rotation with him makes him support all allies by 40% attack. So obviously that means that he's going to be buffing himself as well. So what links do these guys actually share? Oh, they're actually not a bad rotation, I guess, all things considered. So we'll save the standby here. We'll get ourselves a bit of a heal. We'll try and save the STR orbs for Tapion. There we go. So the next turn should be interesting because we're going to have the Piccolo support. Tapion for the unit super, as well as the fact that Tapion provides support himself as well. And then, of course, we will be getting the unit super, Piccolo support, all good on the turn. Goku going off here. Is he going to finish off Frieza? Because the next phase is AGL, so... Well, yeah, well, he's not potentially going to finish him off, but we are going to finish him off this turn, right? Now, how much do you take from this post-super? Yeah, double-digit damage, okay. Really cannot wait for this Goku to come out on Global, but that's going to be April for us over here on the Global side. Be interesting to see if anything has come out to have buffed him since then, right? Because the big thing that will happen for Global before the release of Goku and Harutagan is Saiyan Day. So if the unit from Saiyan Day is a movie hero, or is it Final Trump Card is his other leader skill character, then that'll be very interesting to see, like, that buff for him and his team. So, right. So this rotation, we get solid support is the only link he shares with him. That's the crazy thing, right? He needs a Tapion, but he doesn't really link very well with Tapion, which does seem a bit strange. But, we probably should do this, because I want to try and get the rainbow orbs for Tapion if possible. So let's go for... grab these. Can we make a line to any rainbow orbs? I guess we can drop these like this. And then we get two. Alright, so we'll do that. And then we'll see how we play out this turn. I mean, Trunks' defense is relatively good post-super for a free-to-play unit. But it's one of those things, right? Any free-to-play unit is going to be a unit that you're only really using on the team if you don't have stronger summonable unit options. But I quite like the fact that he can be, in a movie boss's setting, again, a movie boss's enemy setting, obviously, a good support unit without having to have Tapion around. Because they don't link super well. This Tech Tapion is pretty good, but he's going to likely be a third slot floating unit as well. So they're not going to end up being on the rotation together. It does mean Trunks will be giving the 40% defense support in that kind of setup, but it's obviously not like the ideal situation for him. So be interesting to see as the new stages of that movie boss's red zone on JP are releasing. Be interesting to see what the final fight is, who's the new hardest boss. Because I think I said the same thing with the Tapion showcase as well. If the new final boss, like the new hardest event in the game, if it even is, from the new movie boss's red zone, is either AGL as the main boss, or at least starts off as AGL, then some of these tech units that have been having a pretty bad time in the Fusion Zamasu meta could sort of come into their own a little bit more. So he could be good as a free-to-play option. Obviously on Global, if you haven't farmed him up already, you should go ahead and do so, especially if you have a bunch of story keys that you never use. I've thrown him on my Link level team so that when this does eventually... I mean, you've got plenty of time, obviously, but thrown this guy on my Link level team so that when he does come to Global, he will be at full level 10 links. And I mean, this is what this showcase is, right? Rainbow full level 10 links. But it will be interesting to see how the landscape has changed when this stuff does come out on Global. Because I wonder, that's the thing we don't know about this celebration. We're assuming that we are going to get the LR Super Saiyan 3 Goku EZA. If we got the Tapion and Minosha EZA as well, that would be pretty crazy, because his thing is a unit, an ally whose name includes Tapion. So obviously Tapion and Minosha do count for that. So let's go ahead and pop the standby off here so we can see where the super is. Oh, it's at the end. Can we actually... Oh no, he'll be dead by then. So what's Trunks' start of turn defense? Only 147. Probably don't want to be putting him in slot one. So we'll do this. We are on very low HP, actually, I have just realized. But he's not supering, so I suppose it doesn't matter. Piccolo shouldn't kill him because of the type disadvantage. But yeah, let me know what you guys think down below in the comment section. He seems like he could be a pretty okay free-to-play unit. The infinite stacking is kind of irrelevant, with events being short as they are at the moment. But if we do start to get some of the slightly longer events come back, he could be pretty good. I always have to temper my expectations and my sort of standards when it comes to free-to-play units, because I think for a free-to-play unit, he's definitely not terrible. So let me know what you guys think down below in the comment section. So that is going to be it for the video, guys. This has been the Master Ningen. Smash that like button, subscribe to the channel if you are new. Check out the links down below for the Discord and the merch store, and I will see you all again soon. Have a good one!